Welcome to the online video lecture series on digital signal processing. In the last few sessions, we started FIR filter, that is finite impulse response filter. And we also discussed, as per our DTFT, listen carefully, DTFT, the impulse response has an infinite value, okay? So we have discussed this particular issue. The impulse response, which is HD of N, is having an infinite value. And we decided to truncate. Truncate is also called window. That is converting infinite to finite. Is nothing but multiply by a window function. That is a set of value. I told in the last video, just multiplying by 1, 1, 1, like this. The result will be H of N, which is finite. Okay, which is finite. Automatically, this is finite impulse response. Our FIR filter design is ready. This was infinite. But how we will give? We will give you in the frequency response character, which is HD of e power j omega. Then first you use IDTFT. Okay, recall. First you use IDTFT. Convert frequency response to impulse response. First step. Second step, multiply by the window function, which is set of value. That is what I have written here. Totally, we are having 5 windows. One is a rectangular window, Bartlett window or triangular window, Hamming window, Hanning window, Blackman window. Okay. So there are totally 5 windows are available. It is just a set of value. What you should do? Usually we will give you in the question paper, which window? Which window? For example, it is Hanning window. They will give Hanning window. Length of the window, let us say M is equal to 7. Usually it will be odd number because of the symmetricity. M, capital M is equal to 7. M is equal to 9. M is equal to 5. Like that we will give you. So automatically it will be, if it is capital M is equal to 7, it will be 0 to 6. Substitute 0, calculate, get the value. Substitute 1, calculate, get the value. 2, 3, 4, 5. 6, calculate, get the value. Totally you will get 7 values. That 7 value individually multiply with appropriate location, infinite will become finite. You will see in the problem. So step 1, use IDTFT. Step 2, select a window function, multiply. You will get H of N. Step 3, again you take DTFT, result will be H of e power j omega, which is frequency response. So remember, totally we are going to have 3 steps, IDTFT, multiply by window, DTFT. Okay, so you should remember, DTFT, IDFT is the old formula. You should remember window formula which is given here. Please careful in copying. Just make a pass and try to copy all the formula. We just remembering the formula. Now, assume if you have 5 values, here all 5 values are 1, which means from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Totally, you are having 5 values. This side and this side 0. At that particular place, it will be 1. This side and this side 0. So, it will be, looks like a rectangle. So, it is called rectangular window, which means our box window, they used to say. All the values are 1. And here, if you take, just for example, I am saying 5 values. The center value will be calculated as 1. This side, okay, the center value will be calculated as 1. If you try to calculate, this will be 0.50, 0.50. And if you try to join, it will be like a triangle. So it is called triangular window. And if you try to put the Hamming value, that is if you put a 0, cos 0 will be 1.54 divided by -0.46 will be 0.0 to something like this. Then if you put the 1, you will be getting 0.75. Then you will be getting 1. Then you will be getting 0.75. It will be linear phase. Try to calculate that, I will show you the problem. So the values will be like this. It will reach 1 and it will go. If you take Hanning window, the values will be like this. If you see a Blackman window, the values will be like this. Something like this. So these are all the different values I am just plotting. I mean, it is not a big issue. It is immaterial for you. That is the character of the window. Apart from that, when you convert infinite to finite by truncation, or called a window technique, the ideal filter will become, comma, practical filter. Am I right? So there will be a transition width, and there will be some ripples in the pass band as well as the stop band. Now, if you keep on changing the window, the ripple values and the width will change. For example, For rectangular window, width will be 4 pi by m. It depends on the length m. As length increases, width decreases, which is best filter we discussed. If it is barlet window, slightly more. Hamming, all are 8 pi by m. If it is Blackman window, 12 pi by m, it will be very big. So as per this comparison, rectangular window is best because of the transition band. Blackman window will be larger transition band, which is not a good. So rectangular window is best with respect to transition width. And what about this ripple? It should be no ripple, ideally speaking, zero. That is no ripple at all, which means it should have a negligible negative value, which means minus 74 is something like a slight value. Minus 21 will be like this. Okay, if I want to draw this particular area, minus 21 dB. This is minus 25 dB. This is minus 44 dB. Minus 55 dB. Minus 74 dB. Like, which is best? There is no ripple, means it will be Blackman. So, under that situation, Blackman window is best with respect to attenuation, that is smaller one, minus 74, is stop band attenuation. Rectangular window is not that much good, it will be minus 21. Even that knowledge also you should have. So, then which filter is better, which window is better, it is just a trade-off. Okay, don't say middle is the best one. Okay, sir, I am concentrating on narrow transition band, then prefer rectangular. I don't bother about transition band, I want only smooth, I don't want any ripples, then prefer black. Okay, it is just a trade-off between the ripple value and the width. Okay, so when you do calculation, you do please maintain this particular table also in your notes. Okay, and maintain this chart also. Just make a pass and try to count. Based on the previous discussion, let us do some problems. Okay, one low pass filter and one high pass filter we'll try to do. But in question paper, they may ask you either low pass filter or high pass filter. Which window we don't know, so you may have to remember all the window, and what the length we don't know, that is depends on the problem. Okay, just to take note, a low pass filter has to be designed, for the following frequency response, HdF e power j omega equal to, make it 2 omega, which is minus pi by 4 less than equal to omega less than equal to pi by 4, and 0 for pi by 4 less than equal to magnitude of omega less than equal to pi. Determine impulse response filter coefficient using Hanning window NN. Okay, Hanning window for length m is equal to 5. Also calculate frequency response. Just do remember, all the FIR filters form problems are linear phase. All linear phase problems will have e power minus j to alpha omega. That's all. Okay, don't think here the values will keep on change. Okay, usually it will be e power minus j alpha omega. Please do remember. Okay, and at the same time, you will be having 2 alpha plus 1 will be m. Please, this is also one more secret. Always 2 alpha plus 1 will be m. Now it is 2 into 2, 4 plus 1, 5 will be the m. Accordingly, in case if they give m is equal to 7, this will be 3. If it is m is equal to 9, it will be 4. If m equal to 11, it will be 5. You won't get 11 and all because problem will be bigger. Okay, this is logic. Okay, usually in the examination you get 5, 7 and then 9. That's all only you will be getting. Okay, please do remember, it will be alpha omega, 2 alpha plus 1 will be m. Now, what is your low pass filter? The low pass filter character will be ideally like this. Okay, now please remember, it will be 0 to pi, 0 to pi by 4, it will be e power this value with magnitude is 1 e power, okay, that is 1. So that is what they have mentioned here. That's minus pi by 4 to pi by 4 is the value. Pi by 4 to pi will be 0, even negative side also 0. Okay, this is actually 1 e power, so magnitude will be 1. So only see right side, this will be ideal low pass filter. That's what the character will be. In case if it is high pass filter, the graph will be this side, that we will see in the next problem. Now, let us start with the generalized calculation. Always try to remember, the graph will be from minus pi to plus pi, as per I have given just now. In between it will be minus pi by 4 and plus pi by 4. Now what is given? Minus pi by 4 to plus pi by 4 is this value, which is e power minus j 2 omega. Pi by 4 to pi will be 0, mod, which means negative side also, minus pi to minus pi by 4, mod is also 0. This knowledge also you should have. All the problem, make sure that the range is minus pi to plus pi. I made it like this. Now, let us start with the first step. What is step 1 you told? Converting H, capital H to small h, that is frequency response to impulse response using IDTFT. Okay, now let us think. What is your IDTFT? HD of n equal to 1 by 2 pi integral minus pi to pi, if 0 to 2 pi or minus pi to pi, both are one and the same, no confusion. HD of e power j omega, e power j omega n d omega. Okay, so this is the formula we are having. Just I am going to substitute. Very simple maths. Okay. Now, 1 by 2 pi integration. What is HD of e power j omega given? Is the given value. E power minus j 2 omega. Is it everywhere? No, sir. It is only from minus pi by 4 to plus pi by 4. That's all. And that side and this side 0. So, I no need to substitute. E power j omega n d omega. Just let us merge these two. 1 by 2 pi integration minus pi by 4 to plus pi by 4 e power j n minus 2 omega d omega. Am I right? Plus n minus 2 omega d omega. Now if you just do integration e power j n minus 2 omega divided by j n minus 2, your upper limit will be pi by 4, lower limit will be minus pi by 4, outside will be 1 by 2. Now when you substitute upper limit minus lower limit, 1 by 2 pi e power j n minus 2 pi by 4 minus e power j n minus 2 minus pi by 4 divided by j n minus 2. Okay, we are ready. Now this is resembling the sine format. Am I right? This is resembling the sine format, but denominator must be 2j. E power j theta minus e power minus j divided by 2j. This 2 and this j let me replace. This can also be represented as sine n minus 2 pi by 4 divided by 2j utilized pi n minus 2. Okay. So this is your HD of n. Please do remember. And you should also know this is not allowed for n is equal to 2. This formula is for n not equal to 2. Why, sir? In case if you put n is equal to 2, what happened? Just you remember, for n is equal to 2, okay, for n is equal to 2, what will happen? In case if you put n is equal to 2 minus 2, 0, sine 0 will be 0, 2 minus 2, 0, 0, the result will be indeterminate form. Okay, the result will be 0 by 0, indeterminate form. Then how to calculate the value? You should use L'Hospital's rule. Okay, so differentiate numerator separately, differentiate denominator separately, and then substitute your n is equal to 2. Or you try to put n is equal to 2, that is also a general idea. Okay, I will show you. For n is equal to 2, what will be the answer? So 1 by 2 pi integration minus pi by 4 to plus pi by 4 e power j, if you put n is equal to 2, 2 minus 2 0 d e power 0 will be 1. Okay. So what is differentiation of d omega will be omega pi by 4 to minus pi by 4 outside 1 by 2 pi. So 1 by 2 pi is outside pi by 4 minus lower limit will another minus, so it will be plus pi by 4. Okay. So result will be 2 times the pi by 4, 1 by 2 pi will get cancelled. Result will be 1 by 4. Okay. So I can replace instead of 0 by 0. It will be 1 by 4. Okay. Please do remember. Now the answer is, when n is not equal to 0, this value. When n is equal to 2, this value. Okay. So, try to copy. Step 1 is over. Please do remember. Step 1 is over. What is step 1? Given question, substitute in IDTFT, do the calculation, that's all. Every problem e power j only will be getting, sign only will be getting. So limit may change. Okay, instead of pi by 4, they may give 3 pi by 2 or 3 pi by 4. That's all. Okay, just relax while doing this problem. Sir, what is step 2? I would like to multiply HDF and with the window function. Am I right? So, and then I am going to bring the hanging window because it is mentioned in the question paper. HD of n multiply by window function W of n. Result will be h of n. For what value? For n value which is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Because totally m is equal to 5. That's all. Now one by one I am going to calculate. Careful. One small table I am going to maintain. Even you also can maintain this in the examination. Five HD of n you have to calculate, five window function values you have to calculate, multiply will get the five results. That's all, that's the impulse response value. Now we will do one by one, careful. When you put n is equal to 0 here, careful, n is equal to 0, sin of minus 2 pi by 4, 2 and 4 will cancel pi by 2, sin of minus pi by 2, here also n is equal to 0, will put minus 2 pi, okay. Keep the calculator in radian mode and try to calculate. Put n is equal to 0. That's all I am saying. Answer will be answer will be 0.159. Okay. If you put n is equal to 0, the result as per this particular format will be this one. Even you can use your calculator in that formula mode and you can try to substitute. But careful, don't substitute n is equal to 2, you will get error, math error, okay? You put n is equal to 1 here. Put 1 here, 1 minus 2, 1 minus 2 and try to calculate. Result will be 0.225. Put n is equal to 2, don't do, because already n is equal to 2, we have calculated, it is 1 by 4, is nothing but 0.25. Put n is equal to 3 and try to calculate. 0.225. Put n is equal to 4 and try to calculate 0.159. Okay, and please do remember always this value will repeat with respect to central value, this side and this side will be repeat. That is the reason it is called a linear phase filter, it is called a symmetric filter. Later we will see what is symmetric and anti symmetric. Now I calculated HD of n over the derived result. Try to substitute 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, get that. Next window in the same way, remember the window formula, try to substitute 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, get the value, okay. Capital M is equal to 5, my dear, 5 minus 1 will be 4, 2 pi n by 4, 2 pi n by 4, put 0, put 1, put 2, put 3, put 4, try to get the value, okay. So if you try to put 0, cos 0 will be 1, 0.5 minus 0.5 will be 0, okay. If you try to put 1 here and try to calculate, result will become 0 and 0.5 minus 0 will be 0.5. You try to calculate, okay? There also you keep it in radian mode. Then you put n is equal to 2, always this is 4 because 5 minus 1 will be 4. Put n is equal to 2, try to calculate, result will be 1. Put n is equal to 3, try to calculate, result will be 0.5. N is equal to 4, try to calculate, result will be 0. Even that also will become linear phase, no doubt. Now, just multiply individually, that is called truncating or window taking. Just multiply 0 into any value 0. 0 into this value will be 0.1125. 1 into this value will be 0.25. 0.5 into this value will be 0.1125. 0 into this value will be 0. That's over. Now, filter coefficient. Because most of the questions were they asked, calculate filter coefficient. Filter coefficient is h of n is equal to 0, 0.1125, 0.25, 0.1125, 0. Okay, that's all. This is the arrow mark. That's the end of the problem. But actually I have asked one more question, that is also calculate frequency response. Keep it in mind, but right now I am ready with the answer. Okay, just two steps over. Listen my dear, step one, use this formula, get the answer, substitute various value, get the answer. Step two, calculate window values and get the answer, multiply, get the answer. That's all. What is step three? I have to go for DTFT, am I right? This is IDTFT. I have to go for DTFT. What is DTFT formula? H of e power j omega equal to summation n is equal to 0 to minus infinity, infinity will become 0 to m minus 1. Am I right? This is nothing but 0 to 4. H of n e power minus j omega e. Just to try to expand, that's all. Answer will be h of 0 e power 0, h of 1 e power minus j omega 1, h of 2 e power minus j omega 2, h of 3 e power minus j omega 3, h of 4 e power minus j omega 4. Now who is h of 0? 0. Who is h of 1? 0.1125. Who is h of 3? 0.25. Okay. Now if you try to give the answer, your h of e power j omega will be, this is 0, no use, h of 1 will be 0.1125 e power minus j omega. Next, 0.25 e power minus j 2 omega plus 0.1125 e power minus j 3 omega. And this is your final answer. Okay. So this is your frequency response. Try to make it down. This is your frequency response. End of problem. Okay, solid you will get 8 marks. Carefully listen. No complication at all, my dear. So, different problem. Hello, my dear. They may ask you Hamming window. They may ask you rectangular window. Rectangular window means jackpot. All are one. Bartlett window not there in the syllabus. Hamming, Blackman if you want. Okay. So the remember the formula, get the results. Nothing. Just simple integration. That is given value you substitute, given limit you substitute. Try to do the integration, get the answer. It won't satisfy one answer because of 0 by 0. L-hospital rule, or try to substitute directly and get the answer. Okay. This step is over. Next, multiply. This is the step 2 and the result is ready. Last DTFT step 3 is over. Okay, so please do remember, I would like to mention. So this is your step 1 and this is your step 2 and this is your step 3. Okay, DTFT. Okay. So kindly make a note of this particular problem. We'll do another problem. A filter has to be designed for the following specifications. HD of e power j omega equal to 0 for magnitude of omega is less than or equal to pi by 6 and e power j omega for the range. Determine filter coefficient. Filter coefficient means h of. If I ask frequency response, capital H. Okay, that's all. The last third step will be there. Now I ask only filter coefficient, which is only two steps. Determine frequency filter coefficient using rectangular window, so which means it's a very good news, using rectangular window for m is equal to, can you guess? Very good. This is alpha value, m is equal to 7. Okay, please, it's the simplest idea. So what is step 1? Is step 1 is nothing but hd of n is equal to 1 by 2 pi integration minus pi to plus pi hd of e power j omega e power j omega n d omega. But remember, minus pi to plus pi is the range, but I need the limits there. In between pi by 6 magnitude, it means minus pi by 6 also available. Okay, mod omega means minus and the plus, both are included. Now tell me, mod omega 5 by 6 means between minus pi to plus pi by 6, minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 6, this is nothing but 0. What is here? Pi by 6 to plus pi will be e power minus j 3 omega. mod is also mentioned, which means minus pi by 6 to minus pi is also e power minus j 3 omega. Okay, that's the given values. And if you ask me to plot this particular graph, minus pi by 6 plus pi by 6, pi minus pi, and this area will be 0, and this is like this, and even this area is pi by 6 to will be 1 like this. Okay, if you just close one side, good, it is a high pass filter. Okay, just this side close, it's a high pass filter. Anyway, let us not bother about which type of filter. Now, what you should do, just substitute 1 by 2 pi. The integration, I need two areas, okay. So, I have to split the integration into 2. Minus pi to minus pi by 6. Other one will be minus pi by 2 pi by 6, not required. Other one will be pi by 6 to pi. Okay, in the both the places, what is HD of e power j omega? E power minus j 3 omega, e power j omega and d omega. Plus e power minus j 3 omega, e power j omega and d omega. That's all. Okay, just integrate. Just merge, n minus 3 will be there, n minus 3 will be there. Upper limit and lower limit, answer will be with the sign value. Result will be 1 by 2 pi. And if you include for sign, the final answer, that is HD of n will be sin pi n minus 3 minus sin pi by 4 n minus 3 divided by pi n minus 3 for n not equal to 3. Obviously, if you put n is equal to 3, 0, sin 0, sin 0, 0, 0 by 0. When n is equal to 3, what you should do? Just put n is equal to 3 here, and n is equal to 3 in that particular equation, automatically e power 0 will be 1. So d omega, upper limit minus lower limit, upper limit minus lower limit, try to calculate. And you just check it, I have given the answer, it will be 5 by 6. 5 by 6. Okay, now step 1 is over. Try to calculate e power j, e power minus j. Come back, okay. 1 will be pi, other will be pi by 4, okay. Plus j pi, minus j pi, group it. Plus j pi by 4, minus j pi by 4, group it. One will be sine, other one will be sine. Problems, you try it. It's a simple max. Next, I would like to go for rectangular window. What is a rectangular window? Is nothing but always 1. For 0 less than or equal to n less than or equal to m minus 1, which is nothing but 6, and it will be 0 otherwise. Okay, they have given m is equal to 7, so m minus 1 will be 6. Now I would like to create the table. N, HD of n, window function, H of n. Multiplication, okay. So I would like to bring the value 0, 1, 2, 4, 5, 6. Okay, 1 by 1 values, let us calculate. So if you try to put 0 here, 0 here, 0 here, and try to do the calculation, result will be minus 0.106. Okay. And try to put 1 here, minus 0.138. Next, minus 0.159. Next, if it is n is equal to 3, okay, don't put, it will become indeterminate. Direct value 5 by 6, which is nothing but 0.833. Okay. Then again, if you put minus 0.159, minus 0.138, my sincere advice, better you calculate one by one only. Because if you do any mistake, you can identify. After that, you verify whether this obeying the linear phase. This is the central value, this side and this side should repeat. That's all. Multiply by the window function. I told you it is a jackpot, begins all values will be 1. Just if you multiply, result will be same. Minus 0.106, minus 0.138. Minus 0.159, 0.833, minus 0.159, minus 0.138, minus 0.106. Okay, the final answer H of n will be minus 0.106, comma minus 0.138, comma minus 0.159, 0.833, minus 0.159, minus 0.138. Minus 0.106. That's all. So this is the end of the problem. Just make a note. And if you want to do DTFT, you can try. I can just directly give the answer. It's left to you. H of e power j omega answer will be minus 0.106, minus 0.138 e power minus j omega, minus 0.159 e power minus j 2 omega. After getting DTFT answer, plus 0.833 e power minus j3 omega, minus 0.159 e power minus j4 omega, minus 0.138 e power minus j5 omega, minus 0.106 e power minus j6 omega. Additionally, I have given the answer, which is step 3 result. Okay. With this, let us conclude this particular session. It's a linear phase concept. Okay. This particular session. More detail about symmetric and asymmetric filters in the next session. Thank you.